Hello everyone, in this video we shall cover the experiment bioassay of oxytocin by interpolation method. Coming to the aim of the experiment, it is to estimate the concentration of the given unknown sample of oxytocin by interpolation bioassay method. Now tissue used over here is rat uterus. Now coming to the requirements of the experiment, the animal which is required is female rat, as we need the uterus weighing in between 120 to 150 grams. The solutions required are oxytocin, stilbosterol, then digerol solution as a physiological salt solution. And the apparatus required will be the dissection tray, gimbal lever, Sherrington's revolving drum, chymograph, reservoir, stands, forceps, petri plates, then the scissor, pipettes, thread, surgical needle and plasticine to perform the bioassay. Now, coming to the principle of the experiment, the oxytocin. Now, oxytocin, as you all are aware of, it is a hormone which is secreted by the posterior pituitary gland. Now, in this experiment, we are going to use the rat uterine preparation, because that's uterus is quite sensitive towards oxytocin. Oxytocin can induce the contractions in the uterus. So we can use the rat uterus for the bioassay of oxytocin. Now, while using a rat uterus, now one major concern is the estrus cycle. Okay, that is the sensitivity of the uterus towards oxytocin. That completely depends upon the estrus cycle. Okay, so estrus cycle, that too, in which stage of estrus cycle that uterus is, that's very important, because the sensitivity of this oxytocin towards the uterus, that is, it can induce contractions in the uterus only while the uterus is in a particular stage of the estrus cycle. Okay, now how do you identify the various stages of estrus cycle? Okay, so there is a particular method by which you can identify whether the rat is in the estrus cycle or no, and as to in which stage of estrus cycle it is. Okay, so that can be identified by preparing vaginal smears and observing it under the microscope. Okay, a small drop of the vaginal secretion, it can be collected on a slide, and a smear is prepared and it is just observed under the microscope for a particular type of cells. So particular types of cells are observed in a particular stage of the estrus cycle. Okay, so an adult rat, if you consider, so it has an estrus cycle of around about 5 days. Okay, and in this estrus cycle, it can be divided into various stages depending upon the types of cells which are found. So first stage is diestrous stage. Now this is characterized by the presence of leukocytes in the vaginal smear. Okay, so if you see only the leukocytes in the vaginal smear, that means the rat is in the diestrous stage. If you see the presence of a large number of nucleated epithelial cells, so this indicate that the rat is in the estrus or proestrus stage. If you see the cornified epithelial cells, so this indicates that the rat is in the frank estrus stage. And a mixture of non-nucleated cornified epithelial cells and leukocytes, so this indicates that the rat is in the meta or late estrus stage of the estrus cycle. So these are the four different stages, and they are characterized by different types of cells. So you can easily identify the stage of estrus cycle by preparing the vaginal smears. Now, what you will do if the rat is not in the estrus cycle? Okay, now for this matter, if you want to perform the experiment and if you find that the rat is not in the estrus cycle, it can be induced by administration of estrogen preparation, that is stilbosterol. Okay, so this can be injected in the dose of 0.1 ml per kg subcutaneous 24 hours before performing the experiment. So if it is not in the estrus cycle, you can inject this particular dose of stilbosterol and wait for 24 hours. So it will induce the estrus cycle, and then you can observe the stages of estrus cycle by preparing the vaginal smears. And once the rat is in the frank estrus stage, Okay, so phantoestrous uterus is generally highly sensitive towards oxytocin, this one. Okay, so which is characterized by the presence of cornified epithelial cells. So this particular stage is known as phantoestrous stage, and this stage is highly sensitive to oxytocin. So oxytocin acts on the uterus, okay, more effectively when the uterus is in the phantoestrous stage. So you need to identify when the rat is in the phantoestrous stage and then perform the experiment, that is bioassay of oxytocin. Okay. Another problem with this particular experiment is the spontaneous contractions of the uterus. So there may be spontaneous contractions which are not induced by addition of any spermogen. So without adding oxytocin also the uterus can contract. Okay. So this is another challenge. Okay. But this can be overcome by adjustments in the composition of the physiological salt solution or the pH and the bath temperature. Okay, so all these experimental conditions can be adjusted so as to reduce the spontaneous contractions of the uterus. Okay, so also you should make sure that the rat is in the phantoestrous stage. Okay, other stages are less sensitive. Diestrous stage of the uterus, it is relatively less sensitive to oxytocin. So you may not be able to record the contractions, okay, when the rat is in other stages of the estrous cycle. So one thing you should ensure is that rat is in the phantoestrous stage. Okay, and secondly, you need to reduce the spontaneous contractions of the uterus. That can be done by adjusting the experimental conditions. Okay, then coming to the method, that is interpolation bioassay, as we all are aware of, it is less time consuming and yet it is reliable when you compare it with the matching type of bioassay. Another advantage is that the sensitivity of the tissue is determined. Okay, so whether the tissue is sensitive or no, whether it is stable or no, that is done. And if the linearity of the curve is good, one can get the accurate result. The accurate concentration of the unknown sample can be determined. So these are some of the advantages of the interpolation bioassay. Now coming to the experimental conditions, animal used is rat. Muscle isolated or the tissue isolated is the uterus. Okay, then the physiological salt solution uses D-Gelon solution. Volume of thyroid solution used in kept constant is 20 ml. Temperature of the bath is adjusted to 30 degrees Celsius. Basal tension 0.5 gram. Magnification adjusted to 5 to 2. And the doses of oxytocin selected is in geometric proportion. The liver used to record the responses is gimbal liver. Oxygen supplies by aerator. The time cycle which is observed is as follows. That is at 0 minute when you start the response, raise the 0.5 gram weight and start the chirograph to record the baseline of 30 seconds. That is from 0 minute to 0.5 minute. Then at 0.5 minute, add oxytocin and start the chirograph to record the response. The contact time over here is just 30 seconds because it's a fast contracting tissue. So from 0.5 minute to 1 minute is the response which is recorded for 30 seconds. And at 1 minute, stop the chirograph, lower the weight and wash the tissue. Round about at 3 minutes, that is after 2 minutes, washing can be completed. Raise the weight and start the chirograph for the next baseline. So you can see the representation over here. So at 0 minute, you are raising the weight and starting the chirograph to record the baseline. At 0.5 minute, add the oxytocin and start the chirograph. So the response will be recorded for 30 seconds because it's a fast contracting tissue. At 1 minute, you finish recording the response. So stop the chirograph, lower the weight and wash the muscle. Okay, and till it is back towards the previous baseline. Okay, so round about at 3 minutes you can complete the washing. So at 3 minutes raise the weight and again start the chirograph to record the next baseline. So this is a time cycle which is followed. So usually 30 seconds are required to record the baseline, 30 seconds to record the response, 120 seconds for washing. So totally 180 seconds are required, that is 3 minutes time is required to record one particular response. Coming to the procedure of this experiment, first step is to identify whether the rat is in the Easter cycle. Okay, so first thing is done is examination of the vaginal smear under the microscope. Okay, so to find out whether the rat is in the Easter cycle or no, if at all it is in Easter cycle, whether it is in the Frank Easter cycle stage or no. Okay, so if the rat is not in the Frank Easter, okay, or Easter cycle, can be induced by injecting stilbosterol. Okay, so you need to wait for 24 hours after that, and after that you can observe the vaginal smear. So a drop of vaginal wash is taken on the slide, glass slide, and a smear is prepared and it is observed under the microscope. Okay, and find out whether the rat is in the Frank Easter stage. So once it is in the Frank Easter stage, sacrifice the animal, cut open the pelvic region to expose the two horns of the uterus. So one animal, you can have two preparations. You can, two people can perform the experiment over here. Okay, so separate these horns from the surrounding fatty materials and transfer it into a dish which is containing degelatin solution immediately. Okay, now after mounting this particular tissue in the tissue bath of the organ bath, so after this, record the DRC of the standard solution of oxytocin. So while recording the DRC of standard oxytocin solution, the first dose, that is 0.1 ml, it is supposed to be repeated till you get the same heights or almost same heights of two consecutive responses of 0.1 ml. So it should be repeated. So this ensures the stabilization of the tissue preparation. So if you get almost same heights for the same dose which are repeated consecutively, so this indicates that the tissue is stable and you can go for the next response of the oxytocin in the geometric progression. That is, next dose will be 0.2, after that 0.4, 0.8, 1.6, 3.2 ml. So this is the geometric progression in which you are supposed to record the responses of oxytocin till you get the maximum response. That is, maybe you will get the ceiling response. That is, further increase in the dose may not show increase in the heights of the response. Okay, now after this, this is the DRC of standard. After this, record the response of certain volume of test solution. Now, while selecting the volume of the test solution, you should take care that the volume of test should lie in between the volumes of the standards. Or best is the height of the response due to test. It should lie in between the linear proportion of the standard doses, heights which are recorded due to standard solution. So that will be more clear if you see the responses, okay, which will be showing later. Okay, so after recording all the responses, stop the kymograph, label the tracings, measure the heights in mm, and tabulate the results in the observation table. After this, after the calculations are done, plot a graph of log concentration of oxytocin against the percent response. That is, log concentration on the x-axis and percent response on the y-axis. So from this, you can find out the concentration of test solution from the graph and calculate it in terms of micrograms per ml. Okay, these are the responses which are recorded. Okay, so first we have carried out the DRC of standard solution of oxytocin. So here we have seen that 0.1 ml is repeated till you get same height. So here both the heights are same, that is 15 ml. So this indicates the stability of the tissue, that is equipotency. Further, you can continue with the responses in geometric progression, that is 0.2, 0.4, 0.8, 1.6. So you can see that the heights are increasing. And after this, a submaximal dose is again repeated to check for the stability, that is reproducibility. After the standard DRC is completed of the oxytocin, response of test is recorded. We have selected 0.4 ml over here. It can be repeated and average can be taken. So as we can see over here, 0.4 ml is selected. The height is 21 ml and it is lying in between these standard heights. So that's very important. Okay. So this is the observation table. The concentration of the standard oxytocin is 1 microgram per ml. So Here is the data for the standard. The doses which we have selected are 0.1, 0.2, 0.4, 0.8 and 1.6. So the concentration will remain the same since the concentration of standard is 1 microgram per ml. So it will be the same as the dose which you select. Then convert this concentration into log concentration. Okay. So log concentration of 0.1 is minus 1 and 0.2 it is minus 0.6989. So you can see that the log concentration is in the negative range. Okay, so graph will also be plotted accordingly. And you can see that 1.6 is on the positive plot. Okay, so heights again are recorded over here. Okay, due to 0.1 it is 15, as we have seen over here, it's 15, 20, 25, 29 and 33. Okay, so the heights of the responses are recorded in mm. After this, percent response is supposed to be calculated, considering the maximum height response as 100%. So 33 is the maximum height, so this is considered as 100%, and further all the other responses are calculated. So 33 is 100%, so 15 is 45.45. Okay, so accordingly all the percent responses are calculated. Percent response due to test is calculated as 63.64. Okay, so now once you have recorded all the responses and done the calculation, next step is to plot a graph of log concentration on the x-axis and percent response on the y-axis. Okay, so here, as we can see that the 4 points are on the negative scale and 1 point is on the positive scale. Okay, so this point is plotted at 45. Okay, next is plotted at 61. Next point at 76. Next point is plotted at 88, and the last one is at 100. Now, once this plot is ready, okay, against log concentration which are recorded over here. Okay. So once this is done, we know the percent response of the test. So this can be easily interpolated from the DRC of the standard. So 64% response, it can be interpolated to find out the log concentration from the x-axis, and it is found to be minus 0.63. So this is the log concentration of the test solution. So you can calculate further concentration of your test sample as follows. From graph we know that the log concentration is minus 0.63. So by finding out the anti-log, we can get the concentration in micrograms. So anti-log of minus 0.63 is 0.23. So 0.23 micrograms of oxytocin, it is present in 0.4 ml of test sample, as we have selected 0.4 as the test dose. So this is the concentration of oxytocin in 0.4 ml. So further we need to convert it into micrograms per ml. So 0.4 ml contains 0.23 micrograms of oxytocin, so 1 ml contains, cross multiply, 0.23 multiplied by 1 divided by 0.4, so that will give you 0.58 micrograms per ml. So this is the concentration of test sample of oxytocin. So the result is, the concentration of given unknown sample of oxytocin was found to be 0.58 micrograms per ml. This is the reference.